Hey guys, today I have a different type of video for you today. Today, I'm actually reviewing this vintage New Balance basketball sneaker. This is the New Balance BB800. It was made in the 1980s for former NBA player James Worthy, and it was worn by him in the NBA for a short amount of time. This here is a vintage shoe. It never really retroed, and I'm excited to review it for you and see if I can wear it on feet. So I managed to get this pair of BB800s from a vintage reseller on Depop for only $50. And in this condition, it's pretty okay. I mean, there's some normal vintage signs, there's some signs of wear, some creases there, some of the paint on the leather is a little cracked, but other than that, it's in pretty good condition, and as you'll see later, I actually was able to wear them on feet. The rubber is still intact, and obviously it's not crumbling. I know some older Jordans, specifically the Jordan 3 and 4s, the midsoles crack and the air soles pop, which kind of sucks for vintage collectors. But these BB800s have withheld through time. They've aged well, and I'm excited to go in a more in-depth review for you guys. So since James Worthy was a player for the Lakers, this shoe is obviously in the Lakers colorway. This shoe consists of a mostly white upper with some hits of purple and yellow, with some smaller hits of gray around the top of the shoe as well. Like most basketball shoes from the 80s, this BB800 is made up of almost all leather. The leather quality on this shoe is pretty great, especially how they're holding up today. The leather is pretty smooth and solid to the touch, and they feel okay on feet. Obviously, it's a vintage shoe, so it's already been broken in. This BB800 is made up of mostly white and purple leathers with some yellow accents. There's also some gray leather near the top of the shoe around the ankle area. It's a little perforated as well. The New Balance N logo is in purple and yellow, surrounded by the white leather found around the entire shoe. The toe box features a little bit of purple and yellow accents with some perforations near the toe area of the shoe as well. The other side of the shoe features most of the same materials and colors. The tongue of the shoe is made out of white, yellow, and purple leather with a fabric tag featuring the New Balance logo in white, yellow, and purple as well. It also says 800 basketball to indicate the model of the shoe. The back of the shoe features this interesting purple fabric material around the ankle area. It's pretty soft to the touch and it feels good in hand. The back heel area has this nice white leather panel with the New Balance logo painted in purple. It's a little faded because of the vintage nature. The sock liner of the shoe is in the standard purple featured around the other areas of the shoe as well, and it's soft to the touch as well. The size tag is featured on the back of the tongue, and it states the model number, the size, and where it was made. These New Balance basketball shoes were made in China. The midsole of the shoe is the standard white rubber found in most 80s basketball shoes. On this New Balance BB800, you see EVA Core branding on the side with the New Balance logo and New Balance spell out as well. The midsole also features this nice hit of purple stitching around the midsole as well. The outsole of the shoe is made out of exclusively yellow and purple rubber for that Lakers colorway. It also features the New Balance logo and New Balance spell out as well. It's an interesting traction, especially compared to Jordan's and other Adidas basketball shoes and today's New Balance shoes as well. It's a little different from the New Balance 550 as well. The BB800 comes with one set of laces, and that's these flat white laces. Before we go on to the on-feet and fitment section of the video, I need to state first that I am a true size 9.5 in most New Balances, and these are in a size 11.5. Obviously, I can fit in them since they're two sizes up, but you just need to keep in mind these shoes are two sizes above my true size, so just in case they look a little weird, and I definitely won't be able to give you a true fitment guide. Especially, these are also from the 80s, so shoes fit a little differently from the 80s versus now in 2021. So just a little disclaimer before we go into the on-feet section of the video. So after wearing these on feet, they surprisingly weren't too bad for a shoe being two sizes too big for me. But yeah, I mean, as I said before, I can't give you an accurate fitment guide for these since these are two sizes too big for me. But if you have the chance to find these in your size, I definitely recommend you try to get your true size if you can find these. These were pretty hard find, and some of these, some vintage resellers price them pretty high, so don't overpay for these. As for comfort, these feel like most retro basketball shoes, and I mean, they're definitely not painful, but they're meant for lifestyle wear. You're not going to be that comfortable in them. If you're going to be walking around or standing a lot for a while, I definitely don't recommend this shoe. I will say though, because the leather has been broken in, it doesn't feel too bad on this shoe, and it feels nice around the upper of my feet. But obviously the solid rubber outsole isn't the most comfortable thing in the world. I was really glad to pick these up. I've been recently into retro New Balance shoes and the archival models, and it's cool to see how far New Balance has come, especially comparing these with like the Omnis and the Kawhi. It's pretty cool to see how far New Balance basketball has come. If I can find any more archival retro New Balance basketball shoes, I'll be sure to pick them up and leave a review for you guys, because it's a pretty cool thing to find them if they're in a good price. Obviously, there are some retro basketball shoes like old 85 Jordan 1s that are really expensive. Thankfully, the retro New Balances don't fetch too big of a price like the Jordan 1s, so I won't have that hard of a time finding some older New Balance shoes to review for you guys. So that's gonna do it for this video. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed. Follow me on my socials, and I'll catch you in the next one.